Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this quick video, we'll be showing you how you can run the DeepSeek AI models on a Raspberry Pi. Now you won't be running the full DeepSeek AI model on your Raspberry Pi. It just requires way more computational power than a Raspberry Pi is capable of. Instead, we'll be using the distilled variants of DeepSeek R1. You can think of these distilled versions being cut down versions of the full model. What helps make these still usable is the way DeepSeek generated them. Instead of just blindly cutting down the amount of available parameters, they instead used some smart techniques to intelligently select the parameters that should be included in the model. This allowed DeepSeek to significantly reduce the amount of computational power required to run their models. These distilled variants is exactly what will allow us to actually run a version of DeepSeek on our Raspberry Pi. Of course, the Raspberry Pi is still a relatively weak device, so you will need to be cautious about how fast it will be able to generate a reasonable response. We will be testing three of the distilled models on our Raspberry Pi. For this video, we will be using the 8GB version of the Raspberry Pi 5. With AI models, the more computational power and the more RAM you have, the better. Ideally, you would also have a powerful GPU, as they are significantly better at handling AI. But for this video, we'll be simply seeing how DeepSeek R1 performs on the Raspberry Pi's CPU. Now, I'll connect to your Raspberry Pi using SSH or open up the terminal on it. Then, the first thing you want to do is update the package list by typing sudo apt update. Next, you'll want to upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade and then hyphen y. Our next step will be to install the kernel package to your system. Typically this is already bundled with Raspberry Pi OS, but we should ensure that it is installed to your system by typing in sudo apt install kernel and then pressing enter. With kernel now installed, we'll use this package to grab and run the olama install script by writing in kernel space hyphen f s capital L space https://olama.com/install.sh /pipe symbol /sh and then press enter. Olama is a tool that allows us to easily run AI models on our Raspberry Pi. We have a full guide on this tool that we'll link in our description below. With Olama now installed, we'll use it to run the smallest of the available DeepSeek R1 distilled models. This is the 1.5 billion parameter model. It is the fastest model that we can run on the Raspberry Pi and is the one that will get you closest to a real-time response. The drawback of this model is that it is so distilled that its knowledge base is severely limited. It is more prone to inaccuracy and hallucinations. Let's download and run this model by typing olama space run space deepseek hyphen R1 colon 1.5B and then pressing enter. Once installed, let's ask it a simple question, which is, why does it snow? Here you can immediately see the downside of this smaller model. It completely didn't understand the question and produced a garbage response. However, it did generate this response incredibly fast. To see how fast it did generate a response, let's type /by to quit out of the tool and then rerun the command, but this time include the option --verbose at the end. Verbose allows us to see how long it took to generate a response, as well as the amount of tokens it took and how many tokens it was generating per second. With the model running again, let's give it another chance to answer the question, why does it snow? This time, you can see the sort of inconsistencies with the smaller model. This time, it actually understood the question and is giving us a somewhat useful response. It's still not perfect, but it's much better than the first response we got. And it's still generating the response incredibly fast. Thanks to using verbose mode, we can actually tell exactly how long it took. The response took 14 seconds to generate, 38 milliseconds for the model to load. It took 8 tokens to evaluate our question, which took 129 milliseconds to evaluate. This was at a rate of 62 tokens a second. Then the response took 125 tokens to generate. 14.348 seconds was the evaluation time, which equated to a generation of 8.71 tokens a second. Now that we have seen how fast the smallest model is, let us move it up a notch and run a bigger one. First, quit out of the current model by typing in /buy. The next distilled variant of DeepSeek R1 that we're going to run on our Raspberry Pi is the 7 billion parameter model. This contains significantly more data for the AI to utilize, but it will also run significantly slower, as you'll soon see. Run this model by typing in olama space run space DeepSeek hyphen R1 colon symbol 7b space hyphen hyphen verbose and then press enter. Let's ask this larger model the same question we did the smaller one, and that is, why does it snow? You can see immediately that the Raspberry Pi is struggling a lot more to generate the response using the DeepSeek R1 AI. It's still not terribly slow, but you will be waiting for a long time for any response. However, the quality of the response is significantly better. It is producing a usable result right off the bat and doesn't require us to run the model several times to get a decent answer. If you're designing a program that doesn't necessarily need a fast response, this is definitely a viable option to use. Once a response finishes generating, we will then get a quick rundown of how long it took to generate, and here you can see how much slower it is than the 1.5 billion parameter model. While the 1.5 billion parameter was generating roughly 8 tokens a second, this was only generating 2. This shows you the kind of trade-offs that you have to sacrifice to get a usable response on your Raspberry Pi. The larger models are just going to become more and more computationally expensive, which will really put a lot of strain on the Raspberry Pi's limited processing power. Now let's move this along, but this time we'll be running the 8 billion parameter version of DeepSeek on our Raspberry Pi. First, quit out of the current model by typing in /buy. You can run the 8 billion parameter version by typing in olama space run space DeepSeek hyphen R1 colon symbol 8b space hyphen hyphen verbose. Despite the parameter difference, the key major difference between the 7b and 8b models is how they were distilled. All of the other models we used, DeepSeek utilized Qwen 2.5 to distill them. The 8 billion parameter actually uses Llama 3 from Meta. This will change the exact sort of data that has been stored within the model. Like the other models, let's ask the question, why does it snow? Like the 7B model, this version of DeepSeek does generate a quite a useful response on our Raspberry Pi. But it does, like the 7B model, come with a significant cost in generation response time. If you're deciding between these two models on your Raspberry Pi, it's worth throwing the same sort of questions at them to see which one produces the best result. You aren't going to see significant time difference between the 7B and 8B models. However, if time is of the essence and you still want to use an AI model on a Raspberry Pi, then you will have to play around with the 1.5 billion parameter model. You will just need to play around with your prompt to try and ensure that it will reduce the chances of it hallucinating and generating an incorrect and invalid response. DeepSeek shows a huge leap ahead in performance of small devices like the Raspberry Pi. Once the response has finished generating, we can see that it took 56 seconds for DeepSeek to generate a response on our Raspberry Pi. This equated to about 1.98 tokens a second, which is only slightly slower than the 7 billion parameter model. Once you're done, exit out by typing in /buy. Now, if you had a model of the Raspberry Pi with 16 gigabytes of RAM, you could take this even further by running the 14 billion parameter model. This will probably produce the best results, but it does come at even more performance cost. If you wanted to run this, type in olama space run space DeepSeek hyphen R1 colon symbol 14b space hyphen hyphen verbose. Now, as our Raspberry Pi 5 only has 8 GB of RAM, we'll get a memory error. This indicates that there's not enough available system memory for olama to run the DeepSeek model. Hopefully at this point in the tutorial, you should now have a good idea of how DeepSeek R1 can be run on a Raspberry Pi using its distilled variants. If you have found this tutorial to be helpful, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.